Hello everyone, I am Palak, your educator. Welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. We are starting the current affairs compilation MCQ lecture series wherein we will compile current affairs from all the important sources like the Hindu and PIB. Subscribe to Arpita Sharma classes for the daily Hindu news analysis, daily MCQs for prelims preparation, polity classes, economic classes and strategy classes for UPSC, CSE and much more. You can also join our Telegram channel Simplifying UPSC with Ease for class updates and notes. Also, Arpita ma'am is taking live classes on Unacademy Plus. Use code SHARMA20 and get 10% discount. The link is given below in the description box. Okay, so here's the quote of the day. Your limitation is only your imagination. So don't limit yourself. Try to push your comfort zone. Try to get out of your comfort zone. Push your limits. Work hard. Stay dedicated. And I hope every one of you will clear the exams. Okay, let's begin, guys. Where is the Silent Valley National Park located? Where is the location of Silent Valley National Park? Okay, so answer here is A. Silent Valley National Park is located in Kerala in Nilgiri Hills. The national park is one of the last undisturbed tract of southern Western Ghats, mountain rainforest and tropical moist evergreen rainforest. Okay, Nilgiri, it is a core part of a Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve and is a part of Western Ghat World Heritage Site recognized by UNESCO. Okay, you can see the picture. Okay, so next question. Consider the following regarding protocorporation. Okay, first, the flowers of plants that are pollinated by insects and birds is an example of protocorporation. And second, it is an interaction between organisms of different species in which both organisms benefits but neither is dependent on relationship. Okay, which of the above is true? Okay, so answer here is C. Protocorporation is where the two species interact with each other beneficially. They are not dependent on each other. They don't need each other, but they interact with each other because it is of purely gain, purely beneficial. Okay. And the flowers of the plant that are pollinated by insects and birds are benefits from protocooperation. Okay, it is an example of protocooperation. Okay, next question. Where is the Telly Valley Wildlife Sanctuary located? What is the location of Telly Valley Wildlife Sanctuary? Okay, look, the purpose behind adding this sanctuary or biosphere reserve in every session, what I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to make you remember the location of this sanctuaries or national parks or biosphere reserve, so that it will be easy for you to recall if they are asked in exam, okay? Because each and every time there is one or two question, at least one or two question there about the locations of any sanctuaries or national parks or something like that. So I'm just trying to make you remember the things. So tell me the location of Valley Delhi Wildlife Sanctuary. Okay, so answer here is C, the Telly Valley Wildlife Sanctuary is a wildlife sanctuary located in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, see the picture where it is located, the rivers which are flowing through its catchment area, bordered with. So you can have an idea of, clear idea of its location, okay? Go through your atlas after this session and check the location of all these important wildlife sanctuary, biosphere reserve, elephant corridors, tiger reserve, national parks, okay? Okay, so next question. Consider the following regarding India's State of Forest Report 2019. First, the overall green cover has increased in India along with the forest cover in northeast region. And second, the central India are the most vulnerable region to the forest fires in India. Which of the above is true? Which of the following sentence are true as per India State of Forest Report 2019? Okay, so answer here is B. Indian State Forest Report is a biennial publication of Forest Survey of India and an organization under Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Okay, the Indian State of Forest Report assesses the forest and tree covers, bamboo resources, carbon stock and forest fire. For the first time, it has included the qualitative nature of the forest cover. Previously, it was only calculating the area under which is covered by the forest. Okay, the forest covered area, the quantity of the forest cover. But now, what it has built up on calculating the quality of the forest cover, biodiversity, and types of plants and trees found in that region. It has also created the National Forest Inventory on the produce of the from forest, okay, on the forest produce. The findings of Indian State Forest Report is that the overall forest cover in India has increased, but the forest cover in Northeast has decreased, and Maharashtra has the highest increase in the tree cover, okay. Okay, next question. Consider the following regarding Solar and Heliospheric Observatory, SOHO. It is SOHO and not SAHO, so don't think of Prabhas. And the first, it is an indigenously developed by ISRO. And second, it will be launched in Earth Sun L1 orbit. Which of the above is true? Okay, so answer here is B. The Solar and Heliospheric Observatory SOHO is a spacecraft built by European Industrial Consortium, which is led by Matra Macroni Space. Okay, that was launched on Lockheed Martin's Atlas II AS launch vehicle. Okay. It was launched on Martin Atlas II AS launch vehicle. It is a spacecraft built by European Industrial Consortium, which is led by Matra Macroni Space. It is a joint project of European Space Agency and NASA. It is the main source for the real-time solar data and space weather prediction, wind and AC, and discover whether the solar storms occurs, what is the weather, what is AC, what are the winds, and what are the discs. Okay, SOHO is one of the four spacecraft in the vicinity of Sun Earth L1 orbit, L1 point actually. And it is the main source of AC. And what is AC? AC is Advanced Composition Explorer. It is a NASA's Explorer program for solar and space exploration mission to study the matter comprising energetic particles from the solar winds. Okay, to study the energetic particles in the solar winds and the interplanetary medium. Okay. And I have also said discover. Then what is discover? It is a deep space climate observatory, also known as Dhyana. It is also the NASA's space weather, space climate, and Earth observation satellite. It was launched by SpaceX on Falcon 9 launch vehicle from Cape of Carnival. This is a NASA's first operational deep space satellite and became the primary system for the warning Earth in the event of solar magnetic storm. Okay, it gives the warning. It is a warning system to against the solar magnetic storm. Okay, developed by NASA, launched by SpaceX on Falcon 9 launch vehicle from Cape of Canaveral. Okay, so I have also said that it is launched on SOHO, is launched in Earth's L1 point. Okay, then what is that L1 point? That is Langerhans point. Langerhans points are the points near two large bodies in an orbit where a smaller body will maintain its position relative to the large orbiting bodies. Okay, the smaller body maintains its position while orbiting the larger body. Smaller object at Langerhans point will remain in the same relative position. Okay, then what? Okay, if it has the orbit, then why the Langerhans point will have only the same relative position? What happens if the smaller body is not in the Langerhans point and in any other point, so in that orbit, what will happen? That the gravitational force either of the two larger bodies, gravitational force will pull that small body. But the Langerhans point is a point where relatively the smaller body will maintain its position, okay, while orbiting the larger bodies. Other points are non-stable, Langerhans point are stable. Okay, so see the picture. of Soho and see the Lantern Point, you can see that blue point has maintained its position intact. Blue is the body, that the green point where one has been written. You can see the point between two larger body, the yellow one and blue one. The green one has maintained its position and it's orbiting between both of them. Okay, that is the Lantern Point. If it is not there, the green point is not in the Lantern Point. And then what will happen, that gravitational force of either blue body's gravitational force or red or yellow body's gravitational force will pull the green body, the smaller body. Okay, and it will not able to orbit around the bodies. Okay, so next question. Consider the following regarding Operation Sankalp. First, it ensures safe passage of Indian flag vessels transiting through the Strait of Hormuz. And second, it is launched by Indian Navy. Which of the above is true? Okay, so answer here is C. The Indian Navy has commenced the maritime security operation, Operation Sankalp, in the Gulf region to ensure the safe passage of Indian flag vessels transiting through Strait of Hormuz. Okay, to ensure the safe circulation, the safe movement of Indian flag vessels, the maritime security operation, Operation Sankalp, was conducted. It was conducted in the coordination with Ministry of Defence, Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Shippings, and Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gases. You can see the location where it is located. It is located somewhere between UAE, Oman, and Iran. So you can check that location in your atlas. Okay, so next question. Which of the following countries is a part of E3 group of countries? Okay, which of the following country is a part of E3 group of countries? First, Spain, Britain, Germany, or France? Which among these are the part of E3 group of countries? Okay, so answer here is B. E3 group of countries includes France, Britain, and Germany. The three countries highlights its importance in de-escalating the tensions between Iran and Iraq. Their objective is to reduce the tension between Iraq and Iran and to affirmative themselves as an having determination to resolve the fight of Islamic State. Okay. Next question. Which of the following is included in the 8th wonder of Shanghai Cooperation Organization? Which has been included as the 8th wonder of Shanghai Cooperation Organization? Okay, so answer here is C. The Shanghai Cooperation Organization is an Eurasian political, economic, and security alliance. The Shanghai Cooperation Organization (SCO) has included Statue of Unity as the 8th wonder of SCO. Okay. The member countries are China, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, India and Pakistan. Okay, and Afghanistan, Belarus, Iran and Mongolia are the observer nations. Okay, next question. Consider the following regarding GSAT-30. First, it is the communication satellite, and second, it is launched in C and Ku band of geostationary orbit. Which of the above is true? Okay, which of the above is true regarding GSAT-30? Okay, so answer here is C. GSAT-30 is the configured by ISRO in I and K3 band structure to enhance the I and K3 bus structure. It provides the communication service from geostationary orbit in C and Ku band. Okay, it is the communication satellite which helps to provide the communication services from the geostationary orbit in C and Ku bands. Now, what is Ku band? Ku band is a electromagnetic spectrum having frequency from 12 to 18 gigahertz. Okay, while the C band is also the electromagnetic spectrum, but it has the frequency from 4 to 8 gigahertz. You can see the image of GSAT-30. Okay guys, this is the last question for the day. Where is the Gilgi Basin located? Okay, where is the location of Gilgi Basin? Okay, so answer here is A. Gilgi Basin is a large inland geological basin in the western Queensland region of Australia. Okay, it is located in Australia. Thank you everyone. I hope everyone of you liked the video. Please like the video, share it as much as you can. Everyone do attempt the questions, write their marks in the comment section below. And I hope you like the video. Thank you.